A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 17th May, on the front page you have Congress will not insist on Prime Minister's post. So this is Ghulam Nabi Azad on behalf of Congress. He says that the party would reach out to all political allies for government formation and will not insist on Prime Minister's post. Then this is Modi, Mamata target each other over damage to statue. So this is regarding the statue of Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar, which was damaged during the campaigning in West Bengal. So on this, PM has accused Trinamool of erasing evidence of attack. Then below you have US President announces new points-based green card system. So in this points-based system, education, language skills will be rewarded. Then this is Pragya calls Godse patriot, whips up storm. So Pragya Singh Thakur, BJP candidate contesting the elections from Bhopal, she has now called Nathuram Godse, who assassinated Mahatma Gandhi, as a patriot. But she later apologized as per BJP's direction. On page 5 you have repoll in 5 booths in AP, 4 in Kerala on May 19th. So Election Commission has announced repoll in these booths because it had received reports establishing that procedures were vitiated. So procedures were not correctly followed. So now there will be repoll in these booths. There was unauthorized entry. You can see 3 stations had unauthorized entry. So this, in Kerala, bogus voters were found to have cast at 4 booths. Then this is Election Commission moves High Court in IAS officer Mohsin's case. So the Election Commission of India has moved Karnataka High Court in this case challenging the CAT, Central Administrative Tribunal's interim order to maintain status quo on its April 25 direction, asking Karnataka government to hold disciplinary proceedings against IAS officer Mohammad Mohsin. So this is on an alleged misconduct. You should know Mohammad Mohsin, he was initially suspended on April 16 for allegedly violating the instructions related to special protection group protectees. So there is the special protection group protectees, the instructions related to them were violated by him because he ordered videographing and searching of prime ministers, though he clearly states that he searched, but he did not order any videographing. Searching of Prime Minister Narendra Modi's helicopters in Sambalpur in Orissa. So he was subsequently debarred from responsibility as general election observer for the parliamentary constituency in Orissa too. So disciplinary proceedings were initiated against him. So now Election Commission has, he approached the Central Administrative Tribunal, which called for a status quo on such orders. But then now it sees Election Commission has moved Karnataka High Court against him. Then below you have scorching heat forces animals out of Seychellum biosphere. So with water and food depleting here in Seychellum biosphere reserve in Karnataka, the even shy and critically endangered species are foraying into human habitations. So this is a slender taurus, you can see a loris, which is this unique animal which is found here. It's a nocturnal animal, a rare species, but it was loitering in daylight, near dried up water body. So that is showing how such species have been affected. On page 6 you have crop insurance fail, only 8 crore rupees spent on Northeast. So there are 7 states and 4 union territories that are not part of Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana this summer. So out of around 1400 crore earmarked annually for the northeastern states under Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, only 8 crores, or just 0.5%, 0.5% has actually been spent last year. There are 4 northeastern states, Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Manipur and Mizoram, which are not covered under the scheme at all. So that is a serious cause of concern. On page 7 you have proposal to halt waste dumping defeated. So a proposal by India to prevent developed countries from dumping the electronic and plastic waste onto developing countries was defeated. So this was at the Basel Convention in Geneva, the 14th meeting of the Basel Convention. took place, but India's proposal was defeated. The Basel Convention, it lays down guidelines on movement of hazardous waste. Then next is, pact will aid information exchange to fight terrorism, says US Admiral. So this is regarding foundational agreements between India and USA. So we have already signed, you know, various agreements. Now this is regarding the COMCASA, which was signed in 2018. That is Communication Compatibility and Security Agreement. So it enables exchange of information, you know, with respect to even terrorism related cases. So it helps in fighting terrorism is what is highlighted. So India has signed various foundational agreements, but we need to go further also. You can see BECA, Basic Exchange and Cooperation Agreement. And so this is the final foundational agreement which is being discussed between India and USA. There are four foundational agreements which USA has, which it signs with countries with which it has close defense relations. So out of four, three have been signed by India. The only one left is BECA. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is West Bengal Tango. So this is regarding how Election Commission has junked even the pretense of neutrality now, and it has stopped campaigning in West Bengal for all political parties. Then this is slippery slope. So this is how India must not be a mute spectator to tensions rising in the Gulf. So US-Iran relations are becoming tense. So they're slipping further. So this editorial says India should not be a mute spectator. Then the lead article, why an industrial policy is crucial. So this is regarding how no major country has managed to reduce pollution, reduce poverty or sustain economic growth without a robust manufacturing sector. So manufacturing sector is essential for sustained economic growth and also to reduce pollution. So that's why an industrial policy in India is crucial. So arguments for that are made here. And this is the future of Indian democracy secure? So this talks about procedural democracy. So procedural democracy continues, but liberal spirit is in danger of extinction, is what this article argues. Then on the op-ed page, you have on Fridays, you have this parley coverage. So this is regarding the question, is coalition government worse than single party rule? So the success and failures of coalition government is discussed here. And this is encourage citizen science. So this is also very important because these days such citizen science initiatives are seen. So it says new models are needed to supplement the traditional scientific method. On page 10, you have Iran-India discuss visa extension. So talks were held in the wake of sanctions, US sanctions against Iran. So India and Iran are considering visa extensions and further, you know, developments in bilateral relations. On international page, you have images of Iran missiles set off US alert. So photos of weapons on small boats in the Gulf have caused White House to fear an attack from Iran now. And this is coalition planes hit Sana'a after Houthi drone strike. So this is regarding Yemen. So Houthi drone strike took place here, after which the coalition, which is supported by the Western countries, it has hit the region, Sana'a. So it is actually a war in Yemen led by Saudi Arabia and supported by Western powers. So Western powers supporting Saudi Arabia. Then this is technology ban escalates US-China tensions. So this is regarding Huawei. The USA has added Huawei to a blacklist that will make it much harder for the firm to use crucial components. So the order of USA prohibits purchase of equipment from companies that pose security risks. So this is further, you know, US-China tensions escalating apart from the trade war. On business page, you have Reliance British Petroleum combined bids for oil block, Vedanta picks 30. So this is regarding bidding process for oil oil blocks as such. So there are various entities. ONGC is eyeing 20 blocks. Oil India has also bid for 16. So this is regarding open acreage licensing policy, OALP. So bidding for 14 blocks are on offer under this policy, round two of this policy. and also 18 oil and gas blocks and 5 coal-bed methane blocks are on offer under OALP 3 as such. So this is the detail regarding that. And this is GDP numbers suggest high growth in medium term. So the 15th Finance Commission has said that India's GDP numbers suggest a continued high growth trend in the medium term, even though they have fluctuated in the last few years. Then on the last page you have US-UK teams share $10 million XPRIZE award for child literacy. So in this contest, even Bengaluru team was participating. It was among the 5 finalists in this global challenge, the XPRIZE award for child literacy. So this was to teach reading skills to children. So US-UK team has won. The XPRIZE, you should know, is it has been announced by Elon Musk, the entrepreneur and billionaire. So Elon Musk is famous for his SpaceX, the private space agency. So this XPRIZE award is for child literacy, XPRIZE for global learning. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asr.com. Thank you.